Welcome back, adventurers. I'm your average dad, and we're back here at Knott's Berry Farm for the Taste of
Calico.
Yes, I know that on the last video that I had said that I was only going to take maybe an hour or two to enjoy Knott's Berry Farm. Well, actually, I enjoyed both those days. That's why I didn't film. But we did purchase another ticket for today just for you guys. So for today, we're going to be reviewing what we thought of the Taste of
Calico.
We're going to show you our favorite foods that we liked here. And we're also going to be talking about the next event that will be here at Knott's Berry Farm starting August 21st. And that will be the Taste of Knott. So let's go ahead, man. Get into the ghost town, dude, and shove some food down our face. It feels so good to be back in Knott's Berry Farm, dude. I mean, to walk in ghost town again, dude, is awesome. Right over here in these buildings, they brought back something that they originally had here in the 1940s when Knott's Berry Farm first opened up, and that were the pecans. Now, we will come back to show you those later, but right now we're going back over here and we're gonna get two items we really enjoyed. So here at the Wilderness Broiler is the location where you can get that pastrami on that pretzel bun and the lemonade and cucumber. Now that we have the pastrami and a cucumber, let's first off get into this cucumber lemonade, dude. This right here for me was the most refreshing and probably my number two item here at the Taste Ghost Town. It's just so refreshing and cooling, you know, especially in a hot day like this. I mean, it's not really hot. I mean, around 79, probably get high around 83. And look at that, man. They've been throwing a full-on cucumber slice. It's really strong on the cucumber itself, and that's one thing that I really liked about that lemonade. Hold on. These chips that came with the pastrami, they're really, really good. Has that nice crunch to it and has just enough salt to it. So a highlight at the Wilderness Broiler was the pastrami with the pretzel bun, man. Man, dude, that spicy mustard kicks it off. Now, it is a cold sandwich, which, I mean, I don't mind. I mean, the burnt end on the pastrami, dude, is really good. The pretzel bun itself, dude, it's so dense, man. The one thing that I wish it would have had was maybe a little bit of salt on top, just to, you know, give it that little more kick. But I mean, if I want that, I can just, you know, get one of these chips right here, put it in, and there's the salt. Hey, I don't think I'm gonna share the rest of this. Sorry.
So one thing I missed, dude, is this right back here, dude. I mean, people come by on a hot day, boom, set them off and get them wet, dude. Cannot wait for it to open back up.
So if you've been here to the Taste of Calico, what did you think about the cucumber lemonade and the pastrami sandwich, man? Because those two items are probably in the top three for me. What about you? Dude, I'm telling you, it's so refreshing, dude. And now let's go ahead and go into Ghost Town. Go grub some more.
Dude, I dig the music that they play here, man. But we're gonna go down to Ghost Town Grub because we didn't try the bread pudding the last time we were here. So we're gonna go ahead and try that because I heard that it is pretty good. But we are here for this right here, Mrs. Knott's Biscuit Bites with boysenberry butter dipping sauce.
This right here, and this and that butter, for me, is the number one item
that was here at this event, man. I'm telling you. So delicious. Look at that. Everybody's waiting for me to get done filming. But unbeknownst to them, I'm not sharing the rest of it. I don't think I'm sharing anything else the rest of it. Here's the bread pudding. What?
Cream anglaise.
So here's the bread pudding with creme anglaise. My mom tried it and she said she really liked it. So I'm gonna give it a try. It's purple. Boysenberry. That's pretty good. Yeah, that's real good. I like that. If you're a fan of bread pudding, yeah, you have to get that. What do you guys think? If, like I said before, if you were here and tried the bread pudding and Mrs. Knott's biscuits, between those two, which one did you guys like better? Let me know. Comment down below. One thing I think is cool, as soon as we got here around 12:30, they were testing Ghost Rider, dude. They were testing Ghost Rider. I haven't heard a roller coaster or a ride for that matter in so long. So I was just like, I was in awe. And what an awesome too, they have the horse and carriage going around. Now nobody can ride it, but they do have the workers on it and they're going around, man. It kind of feels like home, you know? Hearing roller coaster going around, seeing the stagecoach going around. Man, next thing you know, we'll be hearing a choo-choo of the train, man. See, right there. You can see the Butterfield stagecoach and the horses. Dude, that's so awesome. Dude, that was pretty rad. So, now that we had some sweets, we're gonna mix it up a little bit. We're gonna go ahead and get some chili. Yeah, man. Chili sounds good right now. Yeah?
Yeah.
So here at Judge Roy Bean, you can get that steak chili. Now, this is just one of the areas. And watch, see, look. There you go. Horses are back, sweet. The chili, dude, is really, really good, dude. I really like this. The one thing that I really enjoyed about the chili itself was the boysenberry cornbread, dude. Here is the steak chili with the boysenberry cornbread. And I am telling you, dude, the boysenberry cornbread is what sold it for me, man. So.
And they ask you if you want a side of onions or not, and it's your preferred. You can have onions or if you don't want it, you don't have to have it.
See, and for me, you need onions with chili. So let's go ahead, break some of that cornbread off, a muffin. This is the best thing, watch this. Look at that big chunk, dude, look at that. Look at that huge chunk, dude, of steak, dude, look.
Nah.
Dude, that chili is nice and savory, man. And just like I'm showing you, look. How big, dude. How big a chunk of steak you get in this. And when you break off some of that boysenberry muffin, dude, gives the chili a nice hint of sweetness, man. Actually, I enjoyed the chili this time around more than I did the last time we came. I don't think last time I came there were that big chunks of steak in it. It was just like straight chili, you know, like hormel chili. But this dude, like a full on like chunks of steak, you saw it? They wowed me today with that chili, dude. Yeah, So, actually, that moves on top of the list, dude. That actually is gonna be my number one. That takes my number one spot with those chunks, dude. Chili number one. Touchdown. Game over. Nothing else to do here. Even though we got 12 more items, we established that the chili was the best. I'm going home. The one thing I really enjoyed about the Taste of Ghost Town was how much room was available in between the seating areas. I mean, there was plenty of room for everybody and at safe distances. So we're heading off to the boardwalk area because we're gonna check out the outside facade for the new ride that is coming here. Plus, we're gonna get some corn, some gumbo, and that boysenberry sausage. There is the new facade for the Knott's Berry Tales ride. Obviously, it's done already. We just gotta wait for it to open. I think that's really cool. And if you look right over there, they've actually colored the Wheeler Dealer sign. You can see a little bit of the coloring of the car itself and the back wall. That's cool. And on the side of the building over here, you got that little insignia of the Knott's Berry Tales. So back here in the boardwalk area, they did add some booths just like they had at Summer Nights last year. Now they did add these additional booths after the first week because the first week, these booths were not here and the lines were horrendous. They were just backed up. Now, we were not here the first week, but from friends that we know that were here, they said it. So, pretty awesome that they did open up this area. So, like you can see, we got the gumbo, we got the sausage, and we got the corn up in here. So, the sausage itself is a boysenberry sausage. And if you have been here to the Boysenberry Festival and stuff, you are very familiar with this sausage. Now, I am a big fan of this sausage, but I like it more with the mustard. See that? It's now corn. Famous. World famous for magic here, man. World famous. So, I like it with the Dijon mustard, spicy mustard. Yeah. Now you guys know how I am with my snap, man. And this sausage has that snap, dude, so I approve of it. The sausage itself, you get that nice smoky flavor to it, man. But also you get that nice hint of boysenberry that makes it sweet. We're gonna go ahead and use a boysenberry sauce. Ketchup. For me, the mustard, man, hands down. So the gumbo was one of my favorite, dude. It came with chicken, the sausage, shrimp, white rice. I mean, the gumbo was on point. And I know the gumbo has been here before, but this is my first time trying the gumbo. Sold, dude, sold. If you were here and you tried the gumbo, am I not right? I mean, I'm right, right? About the gumbo? Dude. Now the roasted corn was really good too. You had some of that cojita mojada cheese. I don't even know if that's how you say it, but you had that cheese on there. I am really interested to see how that ride turns out. Now, like I said before, I don't think that it's gonna be a major overhaul. I think it should be, you know, a little touch up here and there. Basically, you know, just the format of the video game itself. Wait, but right now, look what we have up here.
I only do that when I'm being arrested.
It's been a
Well, I gotta go feed my horse, Alan. I'll see y'all later. Have fun!
That was amazing. And he said he had to feed his horse, Alan. Wait, hold on. I'm Alan. So I guess that means we have to shove some more food down our face, dude. We're right here at the lemonade stand, even though I know that's not what it's called. And we're gonna go get some more cucumber lemonade, dude, because like I told you, that was one of my go-to drinks here. And my favorite dessert is here also, which is the icy float, dude. You got some soft serve ice cream on the very bottom, topped with some boysenberry slushy. Yeah, dude. And just like you saw that Mayfield up there, there are certain locations that they will pop up and actually interact with you, man. I like it. It's kind of like a little taste of Ghost Town Alive, dude.
How are you folks over here? Good. You know, it's hard for me because you people want to sit down here and enjoy your meal and you don't necessarily want to look and talk to me, but I'm going to be here for the next 17 hours. You may as well get used to me.
See what I told you, man? So they pop up every so often, this entertainment, man, and it's awesome. But back to this icy float, you gotta drink it down a little bit, so when you do take off the lid, all that icy doesn't pop off. This is the best part. Ice cream at the bottom. So another thing that was awesome that I really liked what Knott's Berry Farm did is the vendors that are usually here during the Boysenberry Festival and Knott's Berry Farm, they actually brought some of them back in and they are here during the Taste of Ghost Town. And I'm pretty sure that they will be here for the Taste of Knott's. So that is really, really cool. Really good to see them, dude. But we are gonna get back in line to go get our three items that we are gonna take home. And one of them is gonna be bread pudding because that bread pudding was pretty good. But going back to what I was talking about when we first came in about the pecans here in Ghost Town, let's go check them out. So these pecans were originally here back in 1940 when Knott's Berry Farm opened, and I think that is cool that they brought them back. So let's look in the sheriff's office.
We're gonna need a form closet to put that Mayfield behind bars. Shouldn't be too hard. One shot tells me she seen him hold up behind a Mayfield's hideout earlier today. Won't you take a couple of minutes? Come around the schoolhouse road.
Now we're gonna make our way down to the barber shop and Hop Wingley and see what's in these. You can barely see him, but Hop Wingley. Right there. And now, on to the assay office.
$6 in cash or $8 in bags.
Get heavy, Augustus! Stop trying to swindle me!
So that was our trip here to Knott's Berry Farm Taste of Ghost Town. Dude, we loved it and loved what Knott's Berry Farm did with it, man. There was so much space, the food was great, it was great to be back inside Knott's Berry Farm, dude. I really hope you guys enjoyed this journey, and I'm glad that you guys were able to come along with us. Now, if you were able to come to this event, let me know your thoughts and what you thought about it. Now, we will be back here on August 21st to bring you a Taste of Knott's. And this time, I will bring you guys a video on the very first day that it opens, man. So I really hope you guys have a great weekend. Thank you very much for all the support and everything, man. Love you guys, dude. And we really couldn't do it without you, dude. And looking forward to seeing you in 2 weeks back here at Knott's Berry Farm with Adventures of an Average Dad, dude. You guys have a good one. Deuces!